welcome back to the EYBL Scholastic here in North Augusta, South Carolina, also home to Peach Jam. And we got a great finale in our triple header today, Long Island Lutheran, Wasatch Academy. And when I say great, top-tier players on both sides of the floor. VJ Edgecombe, top-five player, Jordan Brand, McDonald's All-American. And on the other end, John Mobley Jr., also known as Juni.
Yeah, don't call him Juni. Maybe the best shooter in the country. I mean, this guy splashes it. He's got in-the-gym range and a super soft touch. It's going to be a fun matchup because they may guard each other.
Wow, that would be box office if those two go at it. Of course, Carmelo Anthony in the building to see his son, Kyan Anthony, play, who is on the roster for Long Island Lutheran, too. But there's a player not on the floor today that we should note, and that's Isaiah Harwell.
Isaiah Harwell, one of the best players, certainly one of the best guards in the national class of 2025. That makes him a junior. He's got terrific positional size. He's highly skilled, very efficient floor game, good pull-up, has become a very good three-point shooter as well. Out with an injury, certainly looking forward to seeing him back on the court and healthy sometime again soon.
Yeah, five-star player, offers from Gonzaga, Houston, Alabama, Baylor. We'd be remiss if we had this broadcast and talked about this game and did not mention Isaiah Harwell out of the gate. And I've seen this Wasatch Academy team a few times this year, and they beat that Columbus team from Florida that have the Boozer twins and the Jason Richardson sons as well. And Juni was absolutely spectacular in that victory.
Yeah, again, he can make shot. He forces your defense to extend their pickup point, because as soon as he gets past this center court circle, he's a threat to pull up. So you have to extend your defense, and then when he starts making shots, he can get hot at any time and make them in bunches. So really just a tremendous offensive talent and one of the best shooters in all of high school basketball.
Yes, 6'3", senior, like you said, 47% from the floor, 39% from three-point range, and that's always a bit skewed because he doesn't take open shots.
Right, no doubt about it, yeah. And one of the things you notice when you've watched these numbers, and I'm talking about the real numbers, sometimes in high school, it's almost harder because the kinds of shots you're taking are more difficult in some cases than the kinds you get at the next level because you're at the top of the scouting report.
Now, I was also informed that I should watch number 10, Nigel James for Lujan. Flies under the radar a bit. Even watching them practice earlier today, I was like, oh, I see it.
Well, flies under the radar, nationally ranked, four-star talent, multiple high major offers. But in a setting like this, sure, because there's so much talent on the floor, and you're next to VJ Edgecombe, so sometimes you can go a little bit unrecognized.
Yeah, I say that under the radar, and then Coach Autry at Syracuse wants him to come with Kyan Anthony as a package deal, so not under everybody's radar.
Yeah, no doubt about that.
All right, so the opening tip goes to Wasatch Academy.
Again, one of the other things that makes Juni Mobley so intriguing is that he is committed to Ohio State. But, of course, Ohio State let go of Chris Holtman a few weeks ago. Jake Diebler, the interim head coach right now. But presumably, they are going to make their own hire. What will Juni Mobley do? I can tell you this. He is now being recruited like he's back on the market.
The first shot by Fisher Brown is off.
Fisher Brown is one of those guys who's really had to step up in Isaiah Harwell's absence. Skilled shooter, good complementary piece for this Wasatch team.
Edgecombe. Good looking shot.
That's the part of his game that's really improved, because he was an athlete first and foremost, but the skill level and shot making has really come along.
Brown, 0 for 2. But hey, 1 for 1 to start the day. Ekwe.
I love that ball movement. Guys who just quick move it, know where it needs to go, and gets it there.
Juni outside to Nwili. He's off.
Rulli is an exceptional athlete. I mean, we're talking really explosive and just as competitive.
Speaking of which, right on time, right on target is Nigel James.
Yeah, you like that, right? That's what you wanted. That's what you were waiting for. Used to call that a killer cross back in our day. I don't know what they call it anymore.
Well, we call that a turnover by Christopher Newell. Tim Hardaway with the UTEP two-step.
Yeah, no doubt about it.
VJ Edgecombe looking for the assist to Kate Mingo. Brown thought about it, stepped out of bounds. Two to two game, 2 minutes in. And an offensive foul called on Nigel James, who tosses Juni to the deck.
Yeah, just extending that left arm against the pressure.
Hardest job of the day, this young man. All the bodies on the floor. Mm. Gotta get the sweat
He's
off.
Working too. That hustle.
He's got to get that 40 time up though. I clock him at 5.8.
He's got me beat, I'll tell you that. Oh, got
James,
back.
The steal. And I believe above the rim.
Yeah, that was almost dangerous too. You gotta let a guy get off the ground. Can't touch his legs.
Brown in the corner. Turns it over. Edgecombe headed the other way. And the putback.
Oh, that's the wrong call.
By Ben Michaels.
That's the wrong call. It's the wrong official, too. That's supposed to be the trail.
So they call offensive interference.
Yeah.
But the ball was out of the cylinder.
I thought so.
Okay.
You with me or you with the official?
I'm with you.
All right.
Juni to the bucket.
Ooh. Ouch.
The late whistle, and he is hurt.
Yeah,
he reached for his tailbone.
He hit the ground hard. You do not want to see this.
The grimace on his face, the reach for his lower back,
yeah,
the sound, all of it. And we hope for the best. For those just tuning in, on the ground, John Mobley Jr. leads EYBL in scoring, second in assist. Let's take another look and see exactly what happens. There's the contact.
Yeah.
It looks like he landed on his tailbone.
And we alluded to this in the last possession. It is so dangerous to undercut a player's legs when they are midair. And that's not to say it was intentional. I'm sure it wasn't. But you've got to allow players to land. Otherwise, serious injuries can happen. And again, this is a team already playing without Isaiah Harwell.
Well, it looks like Fisher Brown will step to the free throw line and shoot for Mobley. Brown has been offered by Penn. Let's talk to Vermont, Boise State, UC Santa Barbara, amongst others.
It's a good player. Saw him for the first time this year in October at the Border League out in Las Vegas, where Wasatch played some kind of preseason exhibition type games, and skill level was evident right away.
Sloppy ball handling at the top of the key. Edgecombe gets it back. Edgecombe downhill, and you see the explosiveness.
Left hand too. Great body control in that layup.
Oh. The intensity is there. Brown is denied. Edgecombe in transition again. And a clear offensive foul by Caden Mingo.
So last year, Edgecombe as a junior was the leading scorer in the NIBC, which was kind of the previous iteration of EYBL Scholastic. This season, what we've seen is him really understand how to impact the game without having to be a high-volume shot taker. So he's picking his spots more. He's learning to really assert himself on the defensive end, not wasting dribbles, not forcing bad shots, just a ton of maturity we've seen.
It looks like Juni is on the floor. We saw him go down hard earlier.
Well, that is.
He's going right back to it.
Yeah, I mean, I guarantee you he's not pain-free right at the moment.
So he passed up the open look, got all the way to the bucket. And for his efforts, Nigel James will head to the free throw line.
A little inside out, Hezzy, that time.
James has offers that include Providence, Georgia Tech, Virginia Tech, and Marquette. And Georgia Tech and Virginia Tech are two teams that when we hear offers on the table, they've been very active.
Certainly have been. But they're offering the right guys.
Well, if they're playing the EYBL Scholastic, I would imagine so, sir. And Kyan Anthony subbing into the game, of course, the son of legend Carmelo Anthony, and once a Nick Carmelo.
Carmelo Anthony right under the basket that Wasatch is shooting against. Shooting on, I should say.
Juni, the sidestep for three. And that clinks.
That was a tough shot.
And here's Kyan Anthony getting the ball for the first time. Edgecombe around the horn of the welly. Soft, nice three.
Florida State pledge, that's what he is, a skilled big. Can give you some rim protection. He can also space the floor offensively. Nice pass.
Around in a wide open look is just short. So for Wasatch, great to see John Mobley Jr. back on the floor for them.
Yes, it is.
It was a scare.
Yeah, no, that was, as I said, I'm sure he is still in pain because that was a hard, nasty fall. I got a chuckle, though, watching Coach Peterson walk out there. He kind of goes over, puts up his hand and says, all right, get up, you know, like this.
Edgecombe thought about the three. Pull up instead, got the open look. And another hard spill for Wasatch.
Yeah, it's a physical game. And both of these teams play hard. It's a tribute to both of their coaches, Paul Peterson and John Buck.
Seven to six game, Long Island Lutheran with the lead. Edgecombe once again passed up the open three, and this time it's a turnover.
So his shot is not his core competency. It's a part of his game that's growing and improving, but he's a rhythm shooter right now. He's not a tough shot maker. And you can see just a little hesitant, and I think rightfully so. He wants to have his feet under him, and I think that's where he is in kind of the growth of his shooting. where honestly I thought he could be more aggressive this year. We got a glimpse of it. When he attacks and gets downhill, I mean, he is an absolute just bulldog. And the more he can weaponize his handle and find opportunities to do that, the better he's going to be.
The fadeaway is off by Christopher Nwelle. Tying Anthony to the hole, and he'll head to the free throw line.
Caught the ball with his feet already accelerating towards the rim, so he had a step right off the catch.
He's a 6'5 junior. Offers include Michigan, Florida State, Illinois, Pitt, Seton Hall, Memphis, Tennessee. Took an official trip to Syracuse, where, of course, his dad won a national championship and is here to watch it now.
You know, let me say this. I don't know Carmelo Anthony personally, but when it comes to former NBA players who'd appear to be doing this the right way, he is at the top of the list. I mean, he is saying he's always here. He's always courtside. He's saying that his legacy is his son, but there's no pressure to duplicate what he did. He just wants him to run his own race. I've heard him talk positively about learning through the women's game and how the fundamentals there are good. So I just, everything that he's done as a parent, I just have found really, really admirable.
Excellent points made by you. And the turnover with numbers on the fast break, Jacob Ross.
Jacob Ross is the younger brother of the UConn freshman. They were teammates, Jaden Ross. They were teammates last year at Lehigh. Came up here as Lehigh transitioned into the NIBC, as it was referred to last year. Good pass.
Wide open look, and of course, he's going to make it pay every time. Brown from downtown. Anthony on the baseline. James, nowhere to go. Penetrates and is off. Crashing the board and on the putback is Garfield.
Tell you what, that was a really good offensive sequence from Lehigh to come down, play with pace, and kind of that late transition set, and equally good defense by Wasatch to contain it.
Pressure on the outside. So Juni with the spin step back and is called for travel.
Yeah, and you can see he's just looking, trying to get a look now, but there's nobody out here who can really create offense for him. He's got to be the point guard too, so you can't take the ball out of his hands and run him off staggers or anything like that. So it's a challenge to find some daylight.
6 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Anthony swings it.
Good pass.
Inside the contact on the play, and Ross will go to the free throw line.
One of the things we talked about last game is how AZ Compass shared the ball. They were unselfish. Even though you've got a ton of talent on this floor, nationally ranked, high major recruits, they were sharing the basketball, not worried about who gets how many shots. Lehigh is really encompassing that here through the first quarter.
Ross offers from Georgetown, LSU, Marquette, Maryland, Mississippi State, amongst others. I don't see UConn on that list, where his brother is.
I honestly don't know. UConn is, I think, not the school that is going to throw out a lot of early offers. They, especially since the national championship, they're going to make you work for their offer.
And that's how the first quarter will end. Long Island Lutheran with staggering defense. They have a 6-point lead over Wasatch. And you got to give credit where credit is due. Long Island Lutheran did not have very many bad defensive possessions.
No, they certainly didn't. They've come out, they've competed, they're defending, they're sharing the basketball. It's been a very impressive first 8 minutes.
But we had some highlights in that first quarter, and a lot of them courtesy of Long Island Lutheran. It started with this, the throwdown out of the gate by Ekwe. But here we are, running the floor. Nigel James and company doing that well.
You said he got above the rim, but I love the killer crossover back and forth. And it's a similar mentality, offense from defense. Here's VJ Edgecombe. Watch him get downhill and then the body control at the rim for the easy layup.
And this is what we saw not a lot of outside shooting. Most of the damage was done in and around the paint, really from both teams. Wasatch having some issues getting their offense going.
They're just getting started here. We got three more quarters coming up.
So 15-9 your score as we get ready for the second quarter. For Wasatch, how can they get their offense going from what you've seen?
Well, I think it's going to have to find creative ways to get Juni Mobley some scoring opportunities, because he can't be both the distributor and the scorer. So if they can find somebody else to take on even some part-time ball handling responsibilities, allow Fisher Brown to kind of come off the ball and then run Juni off some screens, that would be interesting to see if it would free some things up. But he's certainly got to try and get himself going offensively here.
This is a game where clearly they miss Isaiah Harwell, who was that perfect complement to him on the perimeter. James steps in, and his aim is off. Ooh.
Tajay Jones off the bench just flew with that offensive glass.
Mobley, the turnover.
Seen a lot of that here today. Some of the young guards getting too deep on their penetration, especially when they're outside the lane. They just get trapped by that baseline.
James pushing it to Ross. Wide by Dagger.
Not the way to get yourself more minutes.
Edgecombe coming up with the loose ball. Ross to James. Anthony, no real estate, but makes the bounce pass to Ross.
Yeah, I love their transition attack. They get down the floor, they space it, they share it, and they get multiple paint touches all within the first couple of seconds of the shot clock. That is a high-level offense that you don't usually see at the high school level.
The work inside, Edgecombe showing the athleticism with the block and the rebound. Anthony, triple threat, pull up. But a travel called on the play.
It's almost as if he grew up watching someone use a jab step really effectively.
I have to admit, I missed this shuffling of the feet. But it was clean.
You can't call Carmelo Anthony's son for a misused jab step. You know what else I love about Carmelo Anthony?
He
doesn't react. You don't see him get like he's just stone-faced there. He's watching the game, not acting like a, you know, emotional parent, anything but.
Edgecombe probing. Enough time, 12 seconds still on the shot clock. And a foul called on the screen on Malik. So Kyan Anthony creating, the defense is there. The nice bounce pass inside to Ross.
Again, that's that transition action we're talking about where you get multiple paint touches, cutters off the ball. It's just pretty stuff from John Buck.
James, nowhere to go. Gets the shot up. Edgecombe, second opportunity, clank. Juni with the long pass, but it's intercepted by Edgecombe.
Buck
and then Edgecombe loses it.
Buck was all over him to push the tempo.
Brown looking for another look from outside. Wasatch has still not scored in this second quarter.
Yeah, neither team really in a great offensive rhythm. And like I said, I've been very complimentary of what Lujai is doing on the offensive end of the floor. They just haven't gotten a lot of shots to fall. Just some basic roll and replace action out of a horn set. Pretty move.
So to your point, it's an 8-point Long Island Lutheran lead. Both teams struggling to score, but you're getting the feeling that Long Island Lutheran are getting better looks at the basket.
Yeah, if you're Wasatch, I think you know you're going into this undermanned, because not just Isaiah Hartwell, it's Malik Diallo who's not in the lineup. You only have 8 bodies right now. You've got to try and play a low possession game, in my opinion, to stay within striking distance. So you're Wasatch. I think you're fairly happy. You know you've got to get some things cleaned up offensively, but you're not losing control of the tempo, and that's what's most important. Lujai, I think, wants to push it, and that's why you see John Beck being really adamant of that on the sideline.
Just constant pressure by Lujai.
Yeah, again, trying to force turnovers, more possessions.
Brown, as open as you're going to get, and knocks it down.
Great pass, too. More possessions you have, the more chance there is for the talent gap to really start to become that much more obvious.
Amazing about that play is John Mobley Jr. on the assist. He did so much to create that open look for Brown. He looked exhausted by the time he threw the pass.
Well, you know his tailbone still hurts after that fall he took, but see, get another look at it here.
So you watch him, exhaustion as he throws the pass, but it pays off with the assists.
And it's pretty, too, because he's skipping that from one side of the floor to the other. That's a pass you don't see in most high school basketball games, to have the vision and the accuracy to skip that over top of the entire floor.
And, again, to give credit to Long Island Lutheran, John Mobley Jr. leads the EYBL in scoring and his second in assists. And that's really the second time in this first half we're like, oh, look, there's a play that he's made. So they've limited his ability to make those big plays.
Well, and the other thing, too, is this is a player whose core competency coming up the ranks has been his shooting. So sometimes there's been discussion about, hey, is he a point? Is he a combo? What is he? Well, he looks like a point guard right now, I'll tell you that. And I've always thought he's a shooting point guard. You know, you never want to compare anybody to the guy in Golden State. But that certainly he's nowhere near that level of talent. But that prototype, I'm saying, is one that more and more young people are trying to emulate. Someone who's a high-level shooter and can also run the team.
It's a 5-point game, under 5 to go in the first half. Edgecombe creates. Ross going baseline. Good recovery by Wasatch.
He's got a huge gap. I would love to see him just attack that.
Wide open look. Knockdown. Caden Mingle.
It's good offense again. Caden Mingle has really had a breakout junior year here for Lujai.
Juni on the miss. Ross on the glass. Strong take to the hole, and he'll head to the free throw line. So Ben Michaels, 50% from three-point range this season. Surprised he didn't take that one. But for his efforts, he's at the charity stripe.
Well, role player extraordinaire. He's long. He's got a strong frame. He can move his feet defensively. He can make it, to your point, an open spot up three. And he doesn't try and do things that he's not supposed to do. So he's always within, you know, the scheme on both ends of the floor, and he's trustworthy. And that's somebody who's being prepared to come in and earn minutes at the college level.
Ben Michaels, all the way from across the pond from the United Kingdom.
He did not play AAU here, though. So he was here last year, then went home, so didn't benefit from a recruiting standpoint from the grassroots season.
And Michaels called for using his hands on defense.
Not allowed. Frowned upon, even.
a full shot clock for Wasatch. On the baseline, Vaughn goes up, and he'll head to the charity stripe.
And those are just mental mistakes, because that's a tough two you're forced. You can't foul in that one.
Scouting report, good athlete, good touch around the rim, and the obvious long arms.
I'm going to find out who these scouting reports have come from.
What if I told you they were from your website?
Oh, 24/7?
That would have been a lie, but what if I told you that? Would we be better friends?
I know the person who does the scouting reports on that website, so I would know whether that was the truth or not.
Is that person you?
It's a team effort, but...
Ross, the pass inside. Some contact. Nothing called on the play.
Good pass.
Brown to the hole. And what a first half it's been for Brown. Wasatch has 16, and he's scoring in double figures.
And Mobley kept his head up the entire way. He made the simple pass, and it was the right pass. And again, Wasatch controlling the tempo of the game, hanging around and giving themselves a chance.
The wide open look. Make them pay, why don't you, Tajay Jones.
Good move.
Brown kicking it back out. Brown,
okay.
So hot he could heat the sun up. 5-point game, just over 2 minutes to go.
Really giving them an offensive spark. And again, it's usually Juni Mobley who does the shooting, but he's got to do the facilitating today.
James with the good pass to Mingo. Mingo.
Very subtle, but good ball fake from Mingo to free himself and allow him to set his feet there, knocking that one down.
Both teams settling in, finding their offensive rhythm. Behind the back, way short.
Yeah, that's not how you control tempo with shots like that.
Ross foul on the way up. John Mobley Jr. saved an easy deuce.
Yeah, Paul Peterson letting him know right now that is not the shot they want. Because here's the thing. When you were trying to limit your opposition's runouts, first thing you have to do is take care of the ball. Second thing you have to do is get good shots. Because when you take contested long shots, it leads to long rebounds, and that allows the opposition to get going in the open court, and that is exactly what Lujai is trying to do.
You know, we've talked about this before. I look at Ross and I go, he averages 3 points per game in the EYBL action, and then, oh, he's a top 100 recruit, has offers across the board.
Yeah.
Georgetown, LSU, Marquette. I guess yeah. You just got to show up when you're on these kinds of teams and play your role.
Well, I think that's it. You figure out a way to impact the game and show your potential without necessarily having the same volume you would in other settings.
Vaughn with a turnover. James, nice finish.
And when VJ Edgecombe is setting the example from that, it's that much easier for everybody else to buy into. I mean, his scoring numbers this year are notably below where they were last year, but it's just all about winning.
Another cross-court pass, Vaughn for three. Can't connect. James with the nice ball handling, then finds Ross. Ross, the second effort pays off.
Yeah, good persistence staying with it. Euro was blocked, but he got his own miss.
Brown can't connect there. And a foul on Ross trying to box out Equin.
Yeah, he was battling on that blockout. Give him credit. He's really fighting here.
Equay, 6'10", junior. Shoots 70% from the field in EYBL action.
Nope, not from the free throw line.
I did not say that, so you are correct. I went with the positive.
Glass half full kind of guy. That, you know what that comes down to? That comes down to knowing where you're supposed to be and staying within your role. And that doesn't mean you're not trying to expand your role in a practice setting. It just means when you get in between the lines for these 32 minutes, you do your job. You try and expand your job on the practice court.
This will be the final possession of the first half. Mingo down low, and it is denied by Ekwe. He averages a block and a half per game. You could see the prowess on that play.
All right, baseline out of bounds, 2.3 seconds left. I'm just saying, beware of the lob for VJ Edgecombe.
And that's how the first half will end. Long Island Lutheran with a 12-point lead over Wasatch. They took the early lead. They maintain the lead. And the defense has been top tier from Long Island Lutheran.
Yeah, give them credit. I mean, this is a Lehigh team that hasn't necessarily found their stride offensively, but they're trying to impose their will and just gradually let their talent and depth be the deciding factor. They're pushing in transition. They're really getting after it defensively, and they are playing hard on both ends of the floor.
Well, clearly that talent and depth you see on both ends of the floor for Long Island Lutheran. And like you said, Wasatch, just eight guys suiting up for this one. Long Island Lutheran taking advantage up and down the floor, the way that they're able to score on the fast break and in the half court set as well. And it's not just one guy, it's a collective so far in this one.
Yeah, and remember what I said about transition. They're playing with pace, they're playing with spacing, they're getting multiple paint touches, and eventually that's going to work. But this guy has been the X factor for Wasatch. Juni Mobley is running the paint, and they got Fisher Brown. He is putting up numbers for Wasatch.
Yeah, Fisher Brown providing all of the offense, the 20 points they have on the board. He's scored in double figures. Meanwhile, the transition, again, a Long Island Lutheran making it happen, the filthy reverse by James on that play. So great, 12-point lead for Long Island Lutheran as we enter the second half of the third of our triple header here on the NBA app and NBA YouTube. We will see you the start of the third quarter. EYBL Scholastic. It's the third game of our triple header between Long Island Lutheran and Wasatch Academy. Chris Miles here with Adam Finkelstein. And I tell you what, my friend, you talk about an impressive first half. Fisher Brown for Wasatch, 12 of their 20 points. And it's been tumultuous for them as far as injuries are concerned. But John Mobley Jr., leading scorer in EYBL Scholastic, second in assists, went down with that hard fall, needed some help, and he provided that.
Yeah, he really did. And then when John Mobley came back in, running the point guard opportunities, most of Fisher Brown's buckets have been coming from Juni Mobley. So they're sharing the ball beautifully, and that's what's keeping them in the game, because this is a deep, talented, and hard-playing Long Island Lutheran team.
Yeah, he's 3-for-6 from downtown. The rest of the team 0-for-5. And you mentioned that from Long Island Lutheran. Every player that played in that first half scored. Mm. So it's been a balanced attack for them, which is the exact opposite.
And made this point, too. Like, when VJ Edgecombe is sharing the basketball and being unselfish, then everybody is going to share the basketball and be unselfish.
And Carmelo Anthony in a good mood because his son on the winning side of that so far had a really nice assist. He's also on the board, has not taken a shot yet, but did go to the free throw line. And that's something we point out about EYBL Scholastic in why it's really healthy as far as how these players look at stats and winning basketball. It's teaching winning basketball.
Yeah, I think it's breeding unselfishness, at least for the teams that win, because you have to sacrifice for the betterment of the team. There's just too many guys and not enough possessions for everybody to get the same amount of volume that they're accustomed to. So different players have to sacrifice, and when they do, the teams tend to do better.
There's John Mobley Jr., 1-for-4 from the field in the first half. 2 assists, 3 turnovers. We've seen him play before. I imagine a better second half from him.
Well, again, though, it's not going to be much easier because he's got to be the point guard and the scorer. So without somebody to create some looks for him, they can't run him off screens. It's just not going to be easy for him tonight. So he's doing what he can do by getting other people involved.
And we're taking a look at Fisher Brown, 4-for-10 from the field. The rest of the team, 2-for-13.
Yeah, he's got 12 of their 20 points, and they're going to have to figure some things out offensively, but I think for the most part, they've got to be pleased with the fact that they have controlled the tempo of this game and kept themselves in striking distance.
If you're Wasatch, you know you're not shooting the ball well, and points are hard to come by. The 10 turnovers, that's really where they got to clean it up.
Yeah, it certainly is, because basically what you've got Juni Mobley, who is one of the best shooters in high school basketball, but today he's having to play as a pure point guard, try and take care of the basketball, get other people involved. Chris Newley has not scored, and we're talking about one of the best athletes and a nationally ranked prospect in the class of 2025. You certainly need more from him.
Yeah, 4-star recruit, has Arizona State, Louisville, South Dakota State, St. John's, all on his list, so clearly a guy who's highly touted.
Yeah, and he has been since he was younger. Another player who's been in the USA basketball system. And then conversely, you've got this Lehigh team. And guess what? They have injuries of their own. Godswill Ahernie, a Seton Hall commit. He's in 21 in black, but he's got that jersey over street clothes because he hasn't been in the lineup for a long, long time. And then you have only eight active players on both rosters right now.
And so Long Island Lutheran will have the ball in a 12-point lead to start the second half.
I think what Lehigh would love to do is win the first 2 to 4 minutes of this quarter and really just create some separation, give them some breathing room here going into the second half. Wasatch coming out in that 2-3 zone again, trying to slow the tempo down.
Edgecombe, turnaround jumper, no good.
That's a good first defensive possession for Wasatch. Good cut. See, they're trying to get him something off the ball. That was a diagram play to try and get Mobley a back cut layup, and it was good, well defended by Lehigh.
And the pass is just off target. So that will be the 11th turnover of the game for Wasatch.
Backcourt violation. It's going to give Lujai a baseline out of bounds. The official not happy that Lujai took their time getting up the floor.
Turnover by Edgecombe on the fast break.
Yeah, he's shooting this. He got hit too. Yep.
And John Mobley Jr. will get three free throws. Might be just what the doctor ordered. His coach is telling him, hey, had a big man running the floor. Reward him.
He said, hey, man, that's the best look I've had all night long. I got to let that fly.
.87% free throw shooter this season.
It's pretty good.
Check out his ranks. First in points per game in EYBL, we've said that. Ninth in field goal percentage, 47%. Seventh in three-point percentage. Third in free throw percentage. Second in assists. Eighth in steals. Tied for first in made three-pointers per game.
And when you do the math on that, I would suspect it comes down to him shooting over 50% on two-point field goals. And for a guy who plays below the rim, who's not the biggest or the strongest or the most athletic, that's, to me, that was the most pleasant surprise of all the numbers you just rattled off.
The corner three is muy bien by Ben Michaels.
Talked about that, his ability to space the floor, being utilized as a stretch four right now. But you have to account for him out to the three-point line.
James on a steal, on the attack. And the flip is off. But who do you know? Guess who's there? Michaels on a book.
Doing all the little stuff. Spacing the floor, offensive glass, providing defensive energy.
And a tough take to the hole. You mentioned him. Christopher Nwuli,
yeah,
on the board.
Got to get him going a little bit.
Wasatch gets the steal. Brown too short, but Ekwe nice and tall.
Yeah, and he drew out Malouk, and that created the putback opportunity for Ekwe. If you're a shot blocker and you go and you don't get it, you go for that block shot and you don't block the shot, you are creating an easy putback opportunity for your man.
So a 10-point game here in the third quarter in some life for Wasatch. And I think this is the kind of play that they need, right?
Yeah, so watch Alir Malouk. He commits, he jumps, and as soon as he does, that leaves his man wide open for the easy putback. And again, these are lessons you learn as a high school player. You learn, hey, I can't go for that unless I feel pretty good about the fact that I'm going to get it, because if I don't, I'm giving up 2 points.
Ekwe has made several impressive plays around the basket, defending, crashing a glass,
yeah,
has made an impact.
Yeah, he certainly has. And again, his role has changed throughout the course of this season because Wasatch down three starters from where they were in the beginning of the season. So he goes from a guy, a backup big man who's providing some energy off the bench to now someone who's the starting center playing real heavy minutes and being relied on to produce.
Under six to go in the third. Long Island Lutheran had a 12-point lead at the half. It is still standing strong at 10, but there's certainly been a momentum shift in the sense of Wasatch finding some rhythm.
Yeah, I think without question. And, you know, the rhythm part is tricky because you're trying to kind of grind it out a little bit, you know, and that's a hard style to get that rhythm in. But I think the zone had been effective until what looked like it was going to be an easy dunk for VJ.
Edgecombe just off on that finish. And here's Juni. He is denied. Wasatch getting it right back. Sloppy ball handling. Wasatch trying to calm it down.
And while VJ has been quiet offensively tonight, I don't think we've talked enough about the fact that he's been locking up defensively. He's been guarding Juni quite a bit.
Brown, too strong. Juni on the board, also too strong. Mingo driving, kicking it out. And what a game so far from Alabama.
They really understand spacing exceptionally well. And again, I'm belaboring the point because it's a really hard thing to get high school kids to not only understand but buy into. They share it, they space it, they play with pace, and it's impressive to watch.
Crashing the glass does not pay off. Long Island Lutheran, they have numbers on the break. A lot of contact on the perimeter.
Yeah.
So we've seen some questionable shot selection of Bowen, and then a lot of contact. A play where it's not necessary.
Right. No, I think that's a fair point. You got to be able to pick your spots. And, you know, fouls are assets. And you've got to deploy those assets accordingly and use them at the right times. 1-3-1 here from Wasatch.
Kyan Anthony checking into the game, getting his first shot off. And it is well shot.
Carmelo, expressionless on the baseline. Doesn't give you a thing.
The tough take to the hole. And Christopher Nwuli will go to the free throw line. A foul will be on Alair Malu.
A little bit of a mismatch there. Wasatch recognized it. Let Nwuli try and take advantage of that athleticism.
You mentioned it at the end of the first half. You said he needs to be more involved here in the second half. Took just 4 shots, 0 for 4 from the field, 0 points in that first half.
And he's one of those guys that's still trying to figure out his game a little bit offensively. He had a big early reputation because he's such a high-level athlete. He had so much defensive upside, and he played so hard. You know, really impressed in some USA basketball settings early on as a freshman. But, you know, you get that big early reputation, that doesn't mean that you can skip steps. And part of that is figuring out what your game is offensively, how it translates to the next level, and continuing to gradually grow your game in the process. And so that's the part that he's still working on, figuring out how to utilize that athleticism to be as effective and efficient as possible.
Ekwe on the glass. Juni for 3. Bucket.
Yep, first open look he's had all night long. Back to a single-digit game here. Lehigh leads just 9.
Edgecombe getting around to Mingo. Anthony's got to put it up. And it's a shot clock violation.
Yeah, I thought Mingo was open when he came off that first stagger, but he didn't really want to shoot it.
Interesting possession where Long Island Lutheran looked to have 2 or 3 good looks early.
Yeah.
They wanted to settle for a better look, and it never came.
And you know what? That's going to happen. That's a price you pay for the unselfish culture that John Buck is obviously building there.
An illegal screen set by Ekwe.
I didn't get a good look at it, but the fact that Paul Peterson not objecting too much and it was right in front of his bench, it's probably fairly telling. Staying in the 1-3-1.
Edgecombe gets the look from the corner in rhythm.
Yeah, finally knocked one down. A little step back.
Here's your McDonald's All-American, Jordan Brand. All-American, Nike Hoops Summit.
Oh, he's got it all. Top 5. Made a really interesting college decision, too, because had all the blue bloods, and he said, you know what? I think I'm going to go to Baylor.
Yeah, I don't. No Duke, no Kentucky, I'm going to Baylor.
But you know what they cited? They said, hey, it went pretty well for Keontae George, went pretty well for Jeremy Sohan. You know, it seems like it's going pretty well for Jacoby Walter right now. If I want to be one and done, they seem to have a blueprint down there in Waco.
Long Island Lutheran holding on strong to that 12-point lead. Kyan Anthony kicking around. Mingo to the basket and one. So Caden Mingo has been relatively quiet so far. Averages 16 points a game. Shoots 58% from the field.
And we talked about it, having a breakout junior season. Part of this really good junior class, because everybody talks about Edgecombe. They've got four nationally ranked juniors as well.
Juni, the nice pass inside. They cannot connect. Ross, emphatic.
John Buck is fired up on the sideline. That is what he has been pushing for, those transition opportunities.
16-point lead for Lehigh, their largest of the game, with 1:30 to go here in the third. And that's a much-needed perfect timeout. You could feel that momentum that was swaying back and forth starting to pull to Lehigh.
And they've tried all game to control the tempo of this one and to stay within striking distance. Bottom line is they're probably just not getting enough offense, but when Lehigh gets runouts like this, you got to do something to break the momentum, because you're going to see it's absolutely spectacular.
And Mingo, we were talking about the scoring prowess. Here he is assisting inside to Ross. It should be noted that Mingo averages 4 assists a game.
Yeah, he's really just, and he's another two-way player. So he's really just someone who can impact the game both ends of the floor in a variety of different ways. As he continues to become more confident in his outside shooting, I think it's going to unlock just more aspects of his game.
Yeah, one of the things that Mingo said, the biggest thing I learned from last season, being consistent, playing with confidence. You got to believe in yourself. Do the things that you work on, because what's the point of working on them if you're not going to do them? Well-rounded
game. Amen. Amen.
He said church. Sloppy ball handling. Wasatch keeps it, though.
VJ Edgecombe made a terrific off-ball switch to save a layup there.
And one right back at you. This time around, it's Bohm going to the charity stripe.
Well, give him credit. There's no quit. They are fighting until the bitter end. They are undermanned, as I said, missing three starters from where they began the season at.
Bohm made the free throw look so smooth and easy.
A little bit of pressure now. Got to be careful with this, though, because if it speeds Lehigh up, that's what they want.
And a turnover. Brown off the bat. Wasatch could still get two possessions here in the quarter. Mobley for three. And the ref called a traveling on that same play for the second time in this game.
Is legal in the NBA. Literally, I think that is literally legal in the NBA by the rules. But according to Federation rules, footwork is just a little different.
Mingo dishing inside. Edgecombe from the corner.
Trap.
Point game, 31 seconds to go, so about a second difference between the shot clock and the game clock here to end the third.
Wow, he was almost landed.
Brown can't connect here in the second half. So Fisher Brown, carry the offense in the first half, has gone ice cold here in the second.
Yeah, that is not a good development from Wasatch because they really needed it. They're basically a two-man show offensively right now unless they can get Nwuli in on the party.
Mingo, too strong, 1 second to go. Mobley.
Oh, it's got a chance.
Beat the buzzer, but is off the backboard. And Long Island Lutheran maintains a 13-point lead after three. They were ahead by 12 at the half. They were ahead by 6 after the first period. They've been leading for the duration of this game, and you got to give credit where it's due. Long Island Lutheran playing and executing an overall good game. Let's check out some of the highlights we have from the first three quarters, and it's mostly Long Island Lutheran, and it's a lot of plays like this. Swing, swing, cash.
Yeah, you can see the unselfishness, giving up good shots for better shots, and that's been the pattern today. Again, the offensive rebounding, that has been something that Wasatch has done a good job of. Cuts there, but the big fella, Lear Malouk, taking that one away. I really think this has been the story, though. You see Luhai scrambling. Yeah, Juni got loose there, but Luhai's defensive effort has really been solid today, and VJ showing why he's a top prospect in the national class. The Baylor commit, five-star prospect, knocking down the corner three.
Yeah, and for VJ, that really seems like he's a top five player in this country. There's one part of his game that is not at that top five part, and he looked good shooting it from outside on that play.
He's made definite strides as a shooter, the overall skill set has, but the defense, I think, is the part of his game tonight that he's putting on full display.
So for Long Island Lutheran, ahead by 13, if you're Wasatch, what is your hope for trying to come back here in the fourth quarter?
You know, I think you're just telling them to take it one possession at a time. You saw them flirt with a little bit of full court pressure there, see if they could get Luhai, surprise Luhai into a couple of possessions. But again, you can't make this a track meet. So this is where it gets tough. The shorter you get on the clock, the more risks you have to take if you're Wasatch. But you've got to give them credit. They're fighting an uphill battle and they're hanging around.
John Mobley Jr. still pleading his case for that step back three that he hit that was taken off the board. Mobley pulling up for three. He'll head to the charity stripe. That's the second time today he's been fouled on a three-point attempt.
Shout out to the ball boy. Got out there real quick. We talked about how Juni really didn't have anyone to throw him the ball. Not like they can run him off of screens when there's no one who can deliver it to him. So he's been forced to try and manufacture his own offense. Step backs, whatever it takes to try and create some space. But this is big because it stops the clock, gives him, potentially cuts the lead to 10.
We often talk about players that are closers. We've seen it time and time again on the EYBL Scholastic Circuit that he's one of those. Starts the fourth quarter with 3 points. Ross hitting the offensive glass. Anthony in and out. Ross back on the boards in Boston.
Jacob Ross has given Luhai some great minutes tonight. He's athletic and he's been a complete live body. Getting his hand on another ball there.
Ekwe. Good look, but can't connect. Edgecombe to the left. No. Second chance opportunity denied by Ekwe, who's been phenomenal defensively.
But that's the part of VJ Edgecombe's game that I actually think we could see more of. Like, I think if he learned how to harness that a little bit, became a little bit of a better finisher when he can't dunk the ball. Like, he's too athletic. He's got to be able to put pressure on the rim more consistently and still find his spots, because that's been, as I said, a great part of his maturation is that he's not forcing his offense, but he's too athletic to settle for jumpers more often than he is getting to the rim.
Mobley. Edgecombe and Luhai heading the other way.
It's interesting to see Kyan Anthony being used as almost a big point guard a lot here today, facilitating the offense quite a bit.
Mingo knocks down his second triple of the game.
Well, that's what he said, right? There's no sense in working on it if you're not going to be confident. I love that. Stepping into the shot and shooting it confident.
Nice dish inside, but the defense is there to force the miss. Edgecombe.
Oh!
Send it home, Edgecombe!
You could see that one coming.
VJ Edgecombe reminded us of why he's an all-everything player. As soon as he got it on the break, he was ready to go.
I mean, just watch the way this guy loaded up as if he's taken off on a runway and explodes to the cup.
VJ Edgecombe made it look too easy. There's been several times in this game where he's looked to attack and someone stopped ball. That did not happen there.
Yeah, you just made a terrific point. I think Wasatch has done a tremendous job on him, surrounding him with orange jerseys in transition and not letting him get loose. That was the one time tonight where he had an opportunity, and he took full advantage of it.
So as we enter the final 6 minutes of this game, Long Island Lutheran, they've extended their lead to the largest it's been all day, 17 points.
That's what we talked about. They weren't necessarily throwing the knockout punch early on. It was just kind of gradually separate, jab, jab, extend the lead as we go. That's what they've done.
Wasatch trying to gain some momentum. Finish this one strong.
This is what we mean about the two-way game of Mingo picking up the ball.
Every screen, he goes from Mingo to Edgecombe defending him. Woolley to the hole, hits the bottom of the rim, and there's contact on his way. I don't think the crowd agreed with that particular call.
Not the New York part of the crowd, anyway. Present company not included.
How do you know they're from New York? Is it because of the Lujai jerseys? Nothing going right offensively for Wasatch.
No, it's one of those days. You have to give them credit, though, because they've had a lot of fight. And that's a reflection of their culture. It'd be really easy to quit, to have the type of losses that they've had, to kind of mail it in. But this is a team that was having a terrific season before some of these injuries. And although they are shorthanded, they are continuing to fight.
Some top-tier, eye-popping wins through February for Wasatch. Dangerous pass.
It was a really atypical angle on the out-of-bounds play because it was essentially in the deep corner.
Mingo all over Mobley. Baum took the contact, but that's one of those. Your coach, you say, hey, you got to learn to finish with your offhand.
Yeah, no doubt about it.
Because he took the contact with his strong hand. And if he went to his offhand, that's an easy finish.
Tell you what, though, Baum's an intriguing guy. A big lefty wing, had good footwork on that catch, held his pivot foot, attacked the closeout. Goes through the lane with long strides. You can see he's got a decent touch, can work on that. Should be able to make shots down the road, but one of those players that, you know, his best days are clearly still ahead of him as he continues to fill out his frame and kind of connect the dots of his game.
Wasatch missed 3 of 4 free throws in that trip. Anthony loses it, but it looks like Long Island Lutheran will maintain possession. You know, I guess our friend that was doing a great job on the floors decided he's done for tonight.
He retired. It's a triple header. He's fatigued. Fourth quarter, game 3.
Maybe he's tired of guys falling on the floor.
Yeah, that could be too.
Edgecombe pulls up for 3. Good money.
Had a little something to say about it too.
It seems with his outside shooting, he doesn't want to go to it, but he's been effective tonight.
Yeah, there's definitely less reluctance to do it than we've seen in the past. I still think there are times where it could be a little bit more fluid, to be honest with you. But when his feet are set, he's plenty capable. And again, that's not his calling card. You know, that's the part he's trying to improve on.
Edgecombe pulling down the board, going coast to coast, and 1. What a second half it's been for VJ Edgecombe. Multiple threes, thunderous throwdown, and now to coast to coast and 1.
Yeah, and that's the stuff where I think there's only so few players in the country who could make that type of decisive play. And the more he can do that, while still playing in the flow, I think the better.
He's going to play for the international team in the Nike Hoops Summit, which is going to be one for the ages.
Yeah, that'll be entertaining, that is for sure. You know, the thing about the Hoop Summit, too, is it's not just another All-Star game. I mean, it's competitive. That USA Basketball, they want to win that game.
Absolutely electric atmosphere every year in Portland, Oregon. Ross cleaning the glass.
Yeah, again, giving him good minutes.
Ross to the hole. Assists by VJ Edgecombe.
Yep, and now you can see they're just breaking it open. It's up to 24.
Breaking, it has been broken. I think the pivotal moment was the VJ Edgecombe thunderous throwdown in transition.
I just think they're better when he asserts themselves. When he asserts himself, pardon me.
Well, the way he's been playing, he could have been multiple people today.
Yeah. But, you know, by the same token, I do think his willingness, he doesn't worry about his stats at all. He, you know, you will never see him pout or sulk if he doesn't get as many shots or as many points. And because he's not taking bad shots, that sets the tone. He's a top 5 player in the country. If he's willing to take less, then everybody else better be willing to take less as well. And by the way, he's their best perimeter defender. So if he's going to defend, everybody else better be willing to defend too. So that's how you get a championship-level culture, is when your best player sets the example on both ends of the floor. Having said that, I think there are times when he could hunt the rim a little bit more.
And Mobley takes the contact and finishes. He had 3 defenders on him during that sequence.
The man's got game. And we haven't even seen really what he does best. You put him out there with another guard, you set some screens for him, you let him come off ball. It opens up. He has an ability to do that like very few others in the high school game.
I'm sure Buckeye fans are excited to hear that he's going to stick to his commitment and attend Ohio State in the fall.
Is he?
According to the reports, Kyan Anthony in and out, but Ross puts it back in.
It's an appropriate punctuation because Ross has had a heck of a day.
and one inside. Tony Noelli gets the finish. So he and his brother both on the floor. And it's a 20-point game with 2:37 to go, so yeah. Wasatch on the comeback. Just kidding, my friend.
A little surprised VJ's still in the game, to be honest.
Kyan Anthony on the assist inside. Mobley, in and out, Edgecombe. Pushing it.
Still playing the right way, still playing in their transition principles.
Mingo turns it over on the break. Edgecombe a little too late. Manu Manciel on the finish.
We are in official stat padding time.
Point game, 1:45 to go here in the fourth. Long Island Lutheran averages 72 points a game, so they're actually a little bit beneath their average.
Yeah, you know, we talked about it. I don't necessarily know that this was an ultra smooth game for them offensively. I thought they ran great stuff. This is like what I tell my kids, right? There's a difference between playing well and shooting well. I think they played really well tonight. I think they stayed within their scheme, and they played hard. I don't know that it was necessarily a great shooting day or an especially clean, like, offensive aesthetic.
So you're going with the aesthetics here?
Yeah, I'm citing aesthetics, yeah.
I'm going to count VJ Edgecombe as aesthetically pleasing in this particular game. But you're right, outside of that, I would concur with your assessment.
I appreciate that.
Knocked down a couple of threes, fast break finishes above the rim.
Oh, listen, there's a reason he's a top five player in the country. And as we said, not to mention the work he did on the defensive end of the floor.
Edgecombe. Off. Anthony kicking it back out to Mingo. He misses. Juni up top to Noelli.
Talked about that high-flying athleticism. He's been known for that since he was an underclassman.
Anthony passed up the jumper. Wasatch heading the other way. And a nice turnaround by Manciel. Get the feeling Lou High going to eat as much of this clock as possible.
Yeah, right now you just want to be classy, want to avoid any potential injuries.
Outside of VJ Edgecombe, who has impressed you the most?
Jacob Ross. Mm-hmm. I think that he played with great energy. I think he utilized his physical tools inside the lane, finished above the rim, stayed within their offensive attack, and he's versatile within their transition attack because you can put him in the dunker spot, short corner. He's a finishing threat, lob threat, but he can also play on the perimeter, drive the ball to the rim, and make a pass. So I really liked what he did for Lujai tonight. You got anybody?
I tell you what, as the game has progressed, Christopher Nwoli has played well down the stretch.
Yep.
But it's really where it's been out of hand.
Yeah, agreed.
Oh, you know what? Cade Mingo. I think when the game was close, Edgecombe took a lot of the pizzazz for the victory. But Mingo did a lot of the work when we had a closer game.
Agree with that as well. Yeah, it was... This is a connected team unit. They share the ball, they defend, they do a lot of the stuff necessary to become more than just the sum of their individual parts.
So Long Island Lutheran comes out on top 66-52. They led wire to wire, and they did it defensively first. Like you said, not the greatest shooting night, but they ran their sets and they played with discipline.
Yeah, it was really, they were connected. They played hard, they played together, they played smart, and that's what you want. And that's going to get it done most nights, even when it's not the best collective shooting night.
So VJ Edgecombe, McDonald's All-American, Jordan Brand, Classic All-American, and also headed to the Nike Hoops Summit. But he's got some business to take care of here in EYBL Scholastic. Great win for you guys.
Appreciate it.
In this particular one. Chipotle National Championship. When you hear that and think about where your team is positioned for that, what does it mean to you?
It means a lot. I mean, we work hard all year for it. You know, that was the main goal, to get there, try to win it all. I mean, it means a lot for us.
VJ, I want to ask you about your mentality. Last year as a junior, you were the leading scorer in NIBC.
Yeah.
This year, you don't seem like you care about stats at all, and that you are setting the tone with your unselfishness and your commitment on the defensive end. So tell me about that maturation.
I mean, they're going to scout me. They're going to scout me to score. You know, I just want to win the game. That's all I care about, to be honest. I don't care about scoring. I don't care about nothing else. I just want to win the game, do whatever it takes for us to win. Last year, it took me to score. This year, I just taking everything I have to do, so it don't matter.
A lot of kids say that. Not a lot of kids back it up with the way they play.
Yeah, and obviously all the honors coming your way, especially you know the way that you guys have played for Lujai. But the Nike Hoops Summit, being able, you know, the guys that have played in that, representing on the international side, how forward to you are you looking to that?
I mean, I'm looking forward to it for sure. I mean, being able to go against the best players in high school around the country. I mean, having them on my team around the world. So, I mean, it means a lot. I mean, I'm just ready to go out there and hoop.
All right, BJ, last question I got for you. Tell me about the work you put in on your jump shot. Because last year, you were attacking, you were dunking. There's been a clear progression in your shooting. We were talking about it. Tell me what's gone into that.
I mean, it's just take reps. Take reps. You know, you can't get bored with doing the right thing. I mean, shooting, after a while, you're going to get boring. We're just going to have to do it. And I mean, you're going to see the outcome of it.
Yeah. Well, I tell you what, it's noticeable, man. Keep doing the work,
yes,
and you're going to keep reaping the rewards.
Yes, sir. Appreciate it, man.
All right. Congrats on all you guys have done and your success here today. And good luck the rest of the way.
Thank you.
Edgecombe.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
What a game from Long Island Lutheran in VJ Edgecombe. Just an overall total balance performance from him.
Yeah, and I tell you what, such an impressive young man. A lot of kids try and say the right thing, but he goes out and he talks the talk and he walks the walk. He really doesn't care about his stats. You can see it in the way he plays. He really is prioritizing defense. You can see it in the way he competes on both ends of the floor. So just really impressed with his maturity.
Yeah, let's check out some of the highlights. And we're going to see some VJ Edgecombe in this for sure. But it started off with Wasatch trying to keep this and make this a close game, but there's Edgecombe getting a steal. And this was really the first play where you go, oh, okay, in transition, something special about him.
Yeah, you see the explosiveness, you see the body control. But early on, I think you had to give Wasatch credit. Their goal was to stay within striking distance to try and slow this game down, kind of make it maybe a little ugly, but just stay within striking distance and have control of the tempo. They did that until the very end.
There's your guy, Ross, who was just electric up and down the floor.
Yeah, he really provided some good minutes here today. Played hard, played with energy. He's such a good athlete. That's shown through both in their transition attack as well as on the defensive end of the floor.
Fisher Brown with 12 of the 20 points for Wasatch in the first half. In the second half, it was Mingo bringing it for Long Island Lutheran.
And we talked about Lujai's transition attack throughout the course of the broadcast. They played with pace. They have great spacing for a high school team. They get multiple paint touches, and they sacrifice good shots for great shots.
And there's one. Look at that form. I mean, Mingo really has a complete overall game. You see him leading the fast break in James with the filthy reverse.
Yeah, Mingo, here's, you're going to see another one, extra pass, and that's the culture. Again, it starts with VJ Edgecombe. if he's giving up some of his individual offense for the betterment of the team, then everybody is expected to do the same. When your star player sets the tone, everybody falls in line.
When you say set the tone, so many defensive plays, even when you see makes by Wasatch, you see hands there. But this is what you were talking to VJ about. The outside shot, he had the J working.
Yeah, he said it's all about the repetitions. The progression of his game from last year to this year is incredibly evident, and it goes back to that maturation that we heard in our post-game interview.
Yeah, there was Ross with another throwdown. And really, Wasatch, you got to give him credit for fighting late in this one. But Long Island Lutheran had it going, and this was it. The transition finish where you felt like the hammer was thrown down.
I mean, that was the punctuation. If that wasn't enough, he said, I'm a better shooter too. How do you like that?
VJ Edgecombe, maybe the J is going to stand for jumpers in the future for him, the way that he's developing. Long Island Lutheran with the win here in the EYBL Scholastic. A great win for them.
Tell you what, great win, great day. Let's do it again tomorrow.
Absolutely. Triple header coming your way tomorrow. We'll be back. We will see you then. Thank you for everyone who's tuned in on the NBA app and NBA YouTube.